So I'm not really into sports, right?
Yeah.
And it's cool. You and Micah are like obviously into sports. Yeah. Is there a lot more athletes that are creative that like I don't know about? Because to me, like, I don't know a whole ton.
Yeah, honestly, I don't think so. Like, I don't think that's like a big crowd, at least from the people that I know that are into like creative things. Like, I think the majority of, I mean, I can only speak for baseball because I don't play any other sport really. But yeah, the people in the baseball world and guys on my team are most all fully invested in baseball. Not that they're like into other hobbies and stuff, but like I'd say I'm like pretty invested into this like art thing, like as well as baseball. So I don't know. I think it's a pretty small crowd in the baseball world. Like as far as like professional athletes go in the art scene, like I don't think you see too many. Like Mike, me, I don't know if you guys have seen Matt Caesar. I think that's how you pronounce it.
Yes.
Yeah, so like he makes some stuff like here and there. So, and those are the really only ones that I know of, but I could be missing a bunch. But as far as baseball goes, there's not too many guys that are kind of in the creative scene, I guess.
I mean, that kind of makes sense. Just like the time investment playing sports is already.
Totally.
Having to do that with art.
Yeah, it's definitely like a lot to do both. But I think it's been a good time for me to be introduced to it with this whole, like, obviously, quarantining, coronavirus, the whole deal and season getting canceled. It was a good time for me to start. Like, I had so much time to just like put into art and to put into drawing and everything. So, yeah, hopefully like once this season, hopefully we play again, I'm assuming we will. I think we should be good. Hopefully I can kind of like figure out how to balance it. That'll be weird. I've been thinking about that. I'm like, well, once like season actually happens, like what's going to happen to my art game, you know? So we'll see. It'll be fun though.
Yeah. I'm curious to see how you're going to balance that.
Yeah. It's already like busy. I feel like, cause I kind of like my day to day is like going out in the morning to like go work out and throw and everything. And then like, come back and like hop on my laptop or my iPad and kind of just get going.
Right.
But it's a lot.
I
can't complain.
I love that you introduce, like it's obvious that you play sports through your work, right?
Yeah.
It's like, you can tell it influences your work. And I think like, to me, like I don't play a ton of sports, but mm-hmm. It's cool to see art based on that. Like I don't really see that all that often.
Yeah. I appreciate that. Yeah, for sure. It kind of all started with like my first like nifty gateway drop. I was like, why don't I just like do my two favorite things, like art and baseball. Like I'll just like do some drawings of like my favorite baseball players. And it's like super simple to me. And it was just like, that was the original idea. So kind of just started drawing what I love, you know, drawing baseball and sports and stuff, but sort of trying to like balance now. I'm kind of like dabbling, like can I do like non-sports art, you know what I mean? Because like I felt sort of like limited, I guess, like with sports. Not that, I mean, obviously like sports is like a huge thing, but I was like, I kind of just wanted to like branch out and like try something new. So
well, it would be cool to see what comes from the heart of Tommy Wilson, like what you're thinking about and what that looks like. I'm curious to see.
I know, right? It's like, it's interesting because I like so many ideas, like so many more ideas I feel like are just like flowing through my head, you know? It's kind of like the opportunities are a little wider. So we'll see where it goes. I know I'm not like done doing sports art, but like just, you know, trying to dabble with something new. So.
Or especially your color palettes, you use such bright colors. It's amazing. I love me my colors. So when I see your art, it's like, ooh, bright colors. I love it.
Yeah, no, I love your colors too. I'm big on like the whole like pop art scene, I guess. And my dad had a big influence on me as far as pop art goes, because he's a painter and an artist as well. And he does those like old school Andy Warhol looking like pop art style paintings, and that's like definitely like need some bright colors for sure. I'm all about that.
Yeah.
Do you have any other artists that you're interested in, just like that inspire you in general?
Recently I've been looking, so recently I've like been doing like 3D stuff on my laptop, trying to like learn that and kind of learn something new, because I see so many like sick like 3D pieces now, and I'm like, geez, like I gotta figure out how to do that, just for like the self-satisfaction, you know, of like learning how to do that, because it's like some of the stuff is so cool. I don't know if you've heard of Damien Hirst. So he's more like sculptures and stuff, but he does like those paintings of those like colorful circles and stuff. He does a lot of cool stuff. So I've been doing a lot of research on him recently, and doing like my next piece, like sort of inspired by him. But other than that, I'm sort of like starting to like explore the art, like the art world. Like I hadn't really, obviously, before, like my whole life's been like consumed by baseball and all I know is baseball. So it's kind of fun now to look at like, I like to pull up a documentary on YouTube about Damien Hirst, or like one of his like galleries from like 2008 or whatever, watching like a video. And do you guys know, I feel like everybody in the art space knows, I don't know how to really pronounce her name. I think it's Yayoi Kusama.
I think so. Does she do the red dots?
She does those like dots in like those mirror room. Yeah. Right. Yeah, I know. I've seen some like people in the crypto art do like sort of her style inspired by her. Super colorful and super bright. But I remember I went, like my dad and my sister took me to her her exhibit in LA, like, I don't know, maybe 5 or 6 years ago. And I was like so not into it. But like now, like looking back, I'd be like so down to like go back with like new, you know, fresher eyes and like a different mindset. But yeah, I'm definitely getting more into like looking at older artists and exploring that kind of stuff.
That's right. So interesting. So when you were younger, did you not expect to take this little art path aside baseball?
Yeah, definitely would have never expected it. I knew like I wanted, like, if like as a fallback from baseball, I would love to be in something like creative, like maybe like running like a social media account for like a team or something involved with baseball, like that has to do with like, I don't know, video editing or something like that. But never thought I would have been like making art. Like that's that, like the last time I was making tech, like, I don't know, technical art was like drawing in class in like the eighth grade, you know, like, I don't know, like that's like, I don't know, like what I like define as art, like me, like actually drawing on a piece of paper, like painting something like a long time ago. So I never would have expected it. So now when I'm like telling people that I know, like, yeah, I got into this art thing, and they're like, what, like art? Then I, you know, have to give them the whole spiel about crypto art.
Right. So you're doing mostly digital?
Yeah. I want to do some like physical stuff, like paintings and stuff. And I did Project X with Carlos, the physical bat thing, which was like really fun and like super sick that we actually like figured out how to get that done like physically. So that was technically like my first like physical piece. So I was super stoked on that because it's like an art wrapped baseball or art wrapped baseball bat. But I definitely want to make some physical art, like a painting or something. But
I'd love to see a painting from you.
Yeah, it's like kind of like stressful. I'm like, geez, I don't know how to make a painting, and like, what do I want to make? Like,
you just got to go for it.
You can't like swipe undo, you know what I mean? It's like you go and it's like, whoa, like
you'll probably try to. Sometimes when I'm painting, I'll like tap my canvas or something.
Yeah, the double tap.
It's embarrassing.
That's funny. Yeah, see, that's what I'm stressed about. But I definitely, like, my dad's got some like canvases at his house and stuff. So he's like offered to like just like come over and just kind of start and get going. But I gotta like, I don't know, I gotta think of what I want to make. Stressful.
That's cool though, to see you exploring 3D and then just the digital art and then wanting to get into painting. I love that.
Yeah, it's, yeah, I mean, I'm kind of accepted, like, I love how, like, I'm, like, obsessed with how so many crypto artists have, like, their own, like, style or color palette. Like, you guys, like, if you see, like, a Fewocious or Jonathan Wolfe, like, you know that's, like, you guys, you know what I mean? Like, it's so indistinguishable. And I think, like, once I got into, like, 3D, I had to kind of, like, accept, like, man, like, I'm too much of an explorer. Like, I just, like, want to, like, dabble a little bit in everything. So I kind of was just, like, you know what, like, even though I want, like, that, like, signature style, like, I just have to accept that, like, I'm just going to, like, keep making, like, different stuff, weird stuff, new stuff, and, like, keep learning. So who knows? Maybe one day, like, I'll stick to, like, a certain, like, style because I think that's sick. But for now, I'm just going to keep, like, learning something new all the time and trying to, like, do something different.
That's the way to go, honestly. I did that, too, where it was really annoying for, like, growing my social media because I'd be trying a new thing every couple months.
Yeah.
And people would get, like, interested in one thing and be like, eh, that's not really me. And then I'd move on. But I think artistically, like, knowing how to do a bunch of different things and, like, knowing what you actually like, that made me, like, a lot more comfortable finding my style. So I think that's definitely the right approach.
Totally. I'm sort of like, I feel like I'm in the mix, you know, I'm like, still kind of like figuring out, you know, like, do I want to keep doing 3D? Do I want to do 2D? Like, and I'm trying to figure out ways to like incorporate both. So I don't know. It's just kind of just a learning process for me, especially being like, I feel like so new to the art world. Like within the last like really year have I invested time into my art. So,
right. So I think that's like, sorry.
Still figuring it out. Yeah.
Right. That's like one of my favorite things about the crypto art world is you weren't like 10 years old and you knew like a guy who ran a gallery and that's how you got into galleries and all that. It's like